those close to him will honor the late nightclub owner at an intimate ceremony in Green Acres near Beaconsfield, a close pal revealed. It's a remarkable decision for him to have made when his professional ambience for 60 years was always rock and roll, they said. He wasn't a churchgoer, so it would have been a bit hypocritical given his naughty lifestyle for him to spend eternity in a churchyard. It's also going to be a lovely focal point for his children, they added. How did Peter Stringfellow? What was the cause of death? It's a remarkable decision for him. Peter Stringfellow's friend, the business mogul, passed away on the morning of June 7 following a secret battle with cancer. Peter's friend said the star hadn't wanted people to see him weakened by cancer, choosing instead to focus on his young family. He became a devoted family man and his last wish was for a green funeral. The insider also said the private ceremony will be followed by a get-together at his famous Covent Garden Club, with celebrity friends expected to step out to pay their respects to the late father of four. His friend said his string of clubs played host to many famous faces over the years and have also seen performances from the likes of the Rolling Stones. Earlier this month, Peter's representative confirmed his death in a touching statement to Kinks and Fleetwood Mac. The eponymous venue first opened in 1980. Known as the King of Clubs, Peter will be remembered for his flamboyant style, charismatic personality and for being a magnet for celebrities across the planet. With A-list stars across six decades flocking to perform and party at his various clubs around the world, Matt Glass said. Peter was diagnosed with lung cancer in 2008, keeping the illness secret for many years before speaking out about it in 2015. UK he had died of a different illness, having previously recovered from the lung cancer. Another representative told Express. He opened up about his first diagnosis in the years before his death, telling the Mirror, "I know I was very lucky and I don't take anything for granted now. I try and look after myself. We eat well and I do most of the cooking at home, and having two young kids really does keep you young." He added. "They are wonderful, and my family, now, are my everything. I was to be around for them." At the age of 68, Peter married his third wife Bella, then 27, and the pair went on to welcome two children together. "I know I won't be here forever, but I do think I am going to make it to 100, he told the publication in the poignant article. "I'm honestly convinced I'm going to make the century, there's no doubt in my mind.